For Crema Media's Polity, I'm Sheila Baradas. Published author Fabienne Francis joins us today to discuss the personality book. What is identity DNA?
Identity DNA is a highly effective people skills and communication training system that changes people's lives in a profound way. It is a system that really teaches you and shows you who you are and your actual personality type.
Personality profiling or analysis has always seemed to be something that we see only in the movies. What made you decide to bring this tool into the mainstream?
You know, I truly believe, Sheila, that personality analysis you can actually use in your everyday life. Since we are very small children, we are taught everything in life. How to do maths, how to write, how to read. But nobody ever teaches us how to understand ourselves with our strengths and our challenges, and also how to understand others. In a world with about 7.7 billion people, it is essential these days to have personality skills. And I've decided that this should not just be reserved for the corporate environment, but it can help people in their everyday life, with their partners, with their families, at the office, even if you just go to the bank, because we are dealing with people from the moment that we wake up in the morning. And it's so important, it makes such a difference if you can really analyze a person and understand it. So it's great fun. You know, my youngest daughter was 9 years old and she could analyze people, and it helped her so much at school and how to socialize with people and how to really understand why people behave the way they do.
What is meant by the term personality?
Personality, you know, there is not one specific definition of personality that was ever really agreed by personality theorists. But basically, personality is who you are from your core. It is a pattern of your characteristics that stays with you right throughout your life. It determines the way you behave in your environment, with people, what you do for a living, who you choose as a partner. So it's who you are.
Is our personality something that we are born with, or is it something that our parents' circumstances and experiences plant within us and we ultimately nurture?
That's a very good question. Thank you for that. You know, my system is called identity DNA or iDNA for the very reason that our personality is, we're born with it. It is in our DNA. It is who we are. But nurture also plays an important role, because our environment, the way that our parents raise us, our culture, all of these things also determine how we apply our personality. Do we use our personality in a positive way? Do we use it in a negative way? All of these things is determined by our nurturing aspect. It's also interesting that in cultures, sometimes a woman is expected to behave in a certain way, which actually classify her in the iDNA personality in the green personality, the natural communicator. You know, this culture expects the woman to be submissive. So sometimes a woman actually has to adapt her personality to suit her environment. But deep within her, if she's a strong red personality type, she's not normally naturally submissive, she will always know that she's not living an authentic life, because you are who you are. It's in your genes, in your DNA.
What are the different personality types that you identify in your book?
You know, iDNA consists of three main personality types. The reason why I've done this is also to make it easy. If you look at the D and the N and the D stands for the dynamic leader. We've colored this personality red to make it easy. And the N is for the natural communicator, and the A is for the analytical thinker. And we've colored that personality purple. Now, we are all a combination of all three personality types. But in most circumstances, you will have a dominant personality with a second supporting, and then we all have what I call the weak link. But there's many different combinations of these personality types. But iDNA is very easy, very fast, and surprisingly accurate. And once you understand it, it's impossible to forget. So, you know, your conversation becomes very colorful because you look around and you see the world through colors. You see a red personality very quickly, a green and a purple, and you see the different combinations of the personalities, and it's very easy to use.
So do you think with the tools that you have in your book that it is possible to read people and predict their behavior?
Absolutely. This is such a fun tool and ability to have because each and every one of us can actually be a profiler. Because from the very first minute that you meet somebody, the person sends you signals. And if you really think about it, personality analysis has been with us from the beginning of time. iDNA is based on the observation of behavior in people. So I teach you with a book and also with my workshops how to analyze a person from that very first contact. The way that they greet you, it's very interesting. Their body language, their tone of voice, the way that they dress, the words that they use in their conversation. So it really gives you the ability to immediately have a snapshot of that person's character and place them in a certain personality group. And if you have the knowledge, which we give you with the book, then you can actually predict their behavior. What is also very important is that it gives you the opportunity to understand a person, really truly understand them. And it takes all the judgmental attitudes away, because you can really see someone for who they are.
Can we apply the personality types that you outline to children as well? And can children also learn about reading people?
Oh, absolutely. I'm very, very excited to tell you today that my daughter, Françoise, she's been a teacher in foundation phase for over 10 years in the private sector in South Africa. She also went to international schools herself as a child, and she has created a personality book for small children. So yes, absolutely, from the age of 4 years old, a child already have formed their personality, of course. They can identify their personality, and through colorful characters, we are now teaching children not only to understand themselves and to own their identities and to proudly say, this is who I am, but also in the home environment. You know, I always say we take our children to school at such a young age, and they have to deal with the teacher, they've got to deal with all these little personalities in the classroom, and we teach them how to actually understand. And on the playground, it helps them also to stand up for themselves and also to avoid being bullied. And once again, like I said earlier, it's time that we also teach our children the importance of personality skills, just with the same willingness as what we are teaching their maths and languages and everything else.
Why is it that sometimes when we meet somebody, we instantly like or dislike them?
Yes, very interesting question, because isn't it amazing? You know, we all have that feeling. You meet somebody and you just feel, wow, I connect with this person, or you meet somebody and you just feel, I don't like the person. What happens is, like I said, you know, from the moment you meet somebody, they're sending us signals. So on some level, if you don't like the person, the signals that they're sending you doesn't really quite fit in your own perspective of the world. Because remember, we look at the world from our own windows, from our own personality type. So this really happens. But once you have an understanding of personalities, you look at a person differently. You know, I always say when you read this book, it comes with a warning, because you never look at people the same again. And even though you might experience this feelings, you are more open before to explore the person and to say, but I understand why you are so reserved. It's not because you're trying to annoy me or you don't like me, but this is just the way that you are. Sometimes we prefer people very similar to us, because it's like looking at a mirror image of yourself, and you're not going to be critical on yourself, or most people are not critical of themselves. But when you meet somebody and they are very different to you, then there's sometimes resistance. With iDNA, we address this, and it makes you more open to accept people.
Can a leopard change its spots? Can people change, or do we have the same personality throughout our lives?
Very good question. You know, my grandmother always said to me when I was a little girl, my darling, remember, a leopard never changes spots. Now, there was some truth in that, because remember, our characteristics do not change. But you do have a choice to be positive or negative in the way that you express yourself. Sometimes you will find you'll speak with a friend and they'll say to you, oh, did you hear or did you see John? He really changed. He hasn't changed his traits, but what he's doing, he went perhaps from the very negative way of using his personality to a more positive way in using his personality. Sometimes you'll find people live a very extreme life negatively, and then they perhaps go and discover personal development, or even sometimes they do one of our courses and they realize that they've been using their personality in the wrong way, and they change, they use it positively. That's the way a person can change. If I should give you an example of the red personality type again, very aggressive personality type, sometimes, particularly when they're younger, they will act on that feeling of anger that they will naturally experience, and they will act out. As they learn through life, through hard lessons, they recognize, oh, I'm getting angry very quickly. But they also have the ability, instead of acting on that aggression, to actually walk away. So, but your traits, your characteristics, stays with you.
You just learn to channel it in a different way, either positively or negatively.
And sometimes it can be another way. Somebody is very positive and use their personality in a positive way, and then they have a major setback in their lives, and suddenly they go into a spiral of negativity, and then you see a change. But that's the only way. It's either negative or positive. But you can't change who you are. If you're impatient, you're going to be impatient until the end of your life. You know, there's an older gentleman that I know very well. And when he was a young man, he would stand by the robot and he would be so impatient. You know, this robot must turn red and he wants to run across the road because he's impatient. Now you take the same man at the age of 80. He might be standing next to the road with a stick, but he's still going to be on edge. And I promise you, when that robot goes green, he's still going to try and get across that road as fast as possible. Yes.
That was Fabienne Francis speaking to Crema Medias Polity about the personality book.